Evans narrated this at the continuation of a trial within trial at an Ika High Court in Lagos, where he is facing a two-count charge of conspiracy and kidnapping alongside six others. Nan said before his testimony, a 5-minute, 33-second video recording was played in the courtroom. The video recording showed Ida Harana, a member of the IGS intelligence response team, sitting beside Evans, cautioning him and taking his statement. Olanrewu Ajinoku, Evans' lawyer, however, disputed the validity of the recording by claiming it was heavily edited. Evans, while being led in evidence by Ajinoku, described himself as a businessman dealing in haulage and ornaments, resident at 3, Fred Soibode Street, Magodo, Lagos. In a graphic detail, Evans described how he was tortured by police officers after his arrest. Harana brought about 25 sheets of paper and asked me to sign. That day, my mind told me not to sign because it might be my death warrant. Philip put his hand in his pocket and brought out a brown hospital card, showed it to me and told me to sign it, saying that do you think that we are joking here? He said if anything happens to me here, this card covers everything. Philip said the police will not be held responsible, and before I knew, Yugu slapped me and that was how they started beating me. The alleged kidnap kingpin gave more details to the court on how the police officers tortured him and made him witness executions in a bid to get him to admit to his crimes. He said, Mr. Yugi was smoking, he quenched the cigarette on my hand. My lord, look at my head where they beat me, my lord, look at my hand. They took me to the backyard of the IG's guest house, I sustained injuries on my head and body. And Philip asked the policeman to walk on me and when I started bleeding, he said do you think we are joking here? At the backyard, I saw some people that I was braided with, they were wearing leg chains. Some of them had bullet wounds on their legs and Philip ordered Harana to bring a big brown sellotape, handkerchief and poly bags. Harana forced a handkerchief into the mouth of one of them, he used the sellotape to tightly tape his mouth and face and put a poly bag over his head and sellotaped it. And used another poly bag and sellotaped it for the second time, and they left the man on the ground. The man on the ground was shaking, he pissed urinated on his body, he poo-pooed defecated on his body and, after a while, he went quiet. Harana went to the man and stepped on his body and he was unresponsive and he told me can you see I have traveled him. Evans told the court that four more persons were executed in the same manner by the police officers in his presence. I was brought before them. And I started begging, asking them what do they want me to do, and they told me to cooperate with them, and I said okay that I will do anything they wanted me to do. Philip asked them to take me to the house, and he asked if I knew the method of killing and I said no, they said that it is called Saddam Hussein. He said that there is no way an autopsy can predict the cause of death of the five people they had just killed, and that those people have traveled. Evans said after witnessing the execution. The 25 sheets of paper were brought for him to sign by the police. He noted he was trembling with fear and Sunny, the second in command to Abakayari, head of the IGPIRT, asked Harana to offer him a can of cold Fanta.